The core network is going to be purely software-based, leveraging the virtualization technologies and providing a software-based solution for all our functions. In addition, we're going to obey the 5G core network principle of cups, control and user plane separation. Jin, can you show us what this will look like?
The core network provides functionalities such as authentication and session management. It houses our data for user profiles, as well as application data, quality of service specification, and policy information. In addition to that, the user traffic will go through a user plane function, which is responsible for monitoring the packets, doing the filtering, allowing the correct packets to come through, and enforcing the quality of service that we've defined through our policy. The core is going to be modularized. It's going to support our control and user plane separation, leveraging the technologies of NFV and SDN, two of the enabling technologies we previously identified. 5G introduces the new concept of a service-based architecture. Rather than defining a reference point like we did in traditional telecommunications, we are leveraging the software and API capabilities. This means that once we add a software function, it registers to a directory so other software functions can discover and interact with it. Because we can add new services easily, the system is scalable. Since we are using software resources both in the core and in the RAN, we can isolate or allocate resources for specific scenarios. By doing that, we're able to group these resources together in what we're calling a slice. Now we're slicing the network for different purposes. Network slicing can allocate resources to offer URLLC to address Zombie Crusher's real-time gaming needs. Another network slice delivers EMBB for Kit's live broadcast to our subscribers. And of course, one more network slice provides MMTC that enables devices in the smart city infrastructure to coordinate and get Frank to work on time. Another opportunity for operators is to group resources to provide a business case scenario, such as mobile virtual network operator or MVNO.
URLLC communications require less than 1 millisecond latency over the air. 5G accomplishes this, but that doesn't account for the end-to-end latency, including network transmission to the application servers and back and forth. How do we reduce latency within the network itself?
Right. There is still additional latency in the network. We need a way to provide computing resources closer to the user's location to reduce the overall latency. To accomplish this, we have a multi-access edge computing solution, or MEC. MEC places virtualized servers close to the radio access network. If users and devices require low end-to-end latency, the application servers can launch the appropriate software in the MEC servers, closer to the user. Let's use Zombie Crusher's video game for an example. A gaming session on Zombie Crusher's device talks to the gaming server somewhere in the cloud. MEC allows Zombie Crusher's device and the gaming server to be closer together. The game server is no longer centralized in the cloud, but closer to where the user is. In addition, the MEC can store cached information closer to where the user is so it loads faster. This cached information could be things like software or videos stored in the MEC platform. Also, the MEC can be used with network slicing to increase the network's efficiency.
Jin, you're saying with MEC, we can allocate resources closer to the user as needed? This allows for a shorter latency and faster turnaround for this user. For applications like real-time gaming, automotive control, or factory automation. With MEC, Zombie Crusher can finally win his battle against the undead.